Assalamu alaikum. Good morning. My name is Raja Salim Akhtar. Welcome in this new video.
Theorem. This theorem gives a relationship or connection between continuity and convergence. Let x comma d1, y comma d2 be two metric spaces and a function f from metric space x to metric space y be a function then f is continuous at a point a in metric space x if and only if for every sequence xn in metric space x which converges to point a in metric space x the sequence fxn converges to f of a in metric space y or this theorem also can be asked in the exam then the following two statements are equivalent statement 1 f is continuous at a point a belongs to metric space x second statement for every sequence xn in metric space x which converges to A, the sequence fxn converges to f of A in metric space Y. Proof directly or first implies second. Suppose function f from metric space X to metric space Y is continuous at a point A in metric space X and to prove the sequence fxn converges to f of A in metric space Y let xn be a sequence in metric space x which converges to point a that is xn converges to a then by definition of convergent sequence given any epsilon greater than 0 there is a natural number n naught such that for all n n greater than equal to n naught implies d1 xn comma a distance of xn and a is less than delta inequality 1 we shall show that the sequence fxn converges to f of a in metric space y for this let epsilon greater than 0 be any real number since f is continuous and a belongs to metric space x our assumption therefore by definition of continuous function at a point for a given epsilon greater than 0 there exists a delta such that for all x d1 distance in the metric space x comma d1 distance of x comma a less than delta implies d2 distance in metric space y comma d2 distance of f of x comma f of a less than epsilon this can be written as by taking x is equal to xn and from 1 n greater than equal to n naught implies d1 xn comma a less than delta implies d2 f of x n note here comma f of a less than epsilon this shows that fxn converges to f of a this implies sequence fxn converges to f of a in metric space y conversely or second imply first suppose for all sequences xn in metric space x which converges to a in metric space x the sequence fxn converges to f of a in metric space y we shall prove f is continuous by using contradiction method suppose f is not continuous at a point a then by definition there exists an epsilon greater than 0 such that for any delta greater than 0 depending upon epsilon and x in metric space x d1 distance of x comma a less than delta but d2 distance of f of x and f of a is not less than epsilon or it can be written as d2 distance of f of x comma f of e greater than equal to epsilon by taking delta is equal to delta n equal to 1 over n, n is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on. We can find a sequence xn such that xn converges to A . This implies xn converges to A, but sequence fxn does not converges to f of A from this, which is a contradiction. Hence, f is continuous. Hence the proof.